Welcome back to CADCAM tutorial. Today we are going to take an advanced exercise in SOLIDWORKS, and here you will learn many things and many features of SOLIDWORKS. So I hope you like it. So let's start to create this advanced model in SOLIDWORKS. This is your exercise number 127. So we will start with this face. This is lies and bottom. If you check in drawing, you will see this side view. This is lies at bottom, and there is one cylinder. Even in section view also you will realize this diameter 58 and length 96 millimeter. And this structure you will see here. These are the structures. So we are going to start with this. And this thickness you will see observed in section view 15. This all structure. So we will start with this 58 millimeter, this outer diameter. Then you will see R16 and R12. There is a hole in this. This corner radius you will see dimension 33, 65, 22.86. Then you will come here, angle 76.06 degree. Then this structure 110.5 millimeter long. Okay, so that's the things we are going to make. So we will start with top plane sketch. First I'll draw a circle. Now this diameter 58, enter. Now let me choose here line and connect here, draw something like up to here, go back to, and you will see it will automatically convert into arc. Then something we have to connect. Don't create any relation, otherwise it creates a problem. Now connect with this. Now these 2 points tangent, these 2 points tangent. Okay, now let me draw center line. Find out center point from here to here to here. Now make relation first. This one vertical. Now hold shift key. This line and this line should be perpendicular. That's the thing. Okay, this point tangent. Now let's define the dimensions. 110.5, 38.5. Okay, now this length 65. Now this point from here 33. Okay, let's correct this one. Okay, let's define this radius R16. Okay, this point from here to here 22.86, angle 22.86. Okay, by default this line is tangent with this, so delete this tangent. Now change. Okay, 76.04 degree. It seems perfect. Extruded boss base. Now first option I'll choose this one, and this length keep end condition blind and length 96 millimeter. Say okay. Again drop, click on the sketch, choose feature extruded boss base, and this time in selected contour I'll choose this one, but here end condition keep blind and the length or thickness only 15. Say yes. Fill it. This corner is 8 millimeter, these two corners. Okay, again fill it, and this corner it's 20 millimeter. Constant type, radius 20, say yes. Now here hole is 12 millimeter. So I'll go to hole wizard and simply I'll choose a hole. Okay, any standard, but DIN standard. Here I'll choose drill. Even though you can find out from here, or even though directly you can write. Millimeter, and here end condition you have to define, so I'll say through all. Okay, position, click on the face and it will ask you place, so keep cursor near circular edge and you will find origin point, you will see here. Okay, escape key to out, isometric view, and you will see the preview. Okay, that's it. Let's now it's properly visible. Now there is one cutout. You will see 56 millimeter and 5 millimeter thick. So first create a plane, then we will cut. And there is some more holes here. You will see 4 number of 6 diameter holes. And this distance 30, distance from outer edge 45. And then center there is one more hole, that's 10 millimeter. Okay, this is throughout hole. And okay, let's do this. So first, okay, let's make a plane. Select this face and this face, and we are going to create a middle plane. Say okay. Now click on the plane. Even though you can make on top, but middle is perfect thing. Sketch. Now I'll select this face. Convert entity. So no need to draw anything. Simply choose a line. Connect from here to here. Now select this line and this line. Parallel relation, this is important relation. Smart dimension, activate smart dimension, and this distance 56 millimeter. Now activate trim entities. Just hold power trim, hold and drag your mouse and see, it's going to trim. So this one we need. Okay, now activate extruded cut feature. Now here choose mid plane, because we are in between. And how much we need to cut? 5 millimeter. See, it's going to cut 2.5 in one direction, 2.5 in another direction. Say yes. Look, click hide plane. Now directly I'll go to hole wizard. Now I want to create a hole, so I'll choose hole, and DIN standard, or even though isometric also enough, but let's keep this one. Now this hole diameter is 6 millimeter. Here keep end condition through all. Go to position, select this one. Now first position, this is the point, center point of this arc. Okay, now the second one, escape key tool, let's make a center line. Now make parallel. And distance 30 millimeter. Let me choose one more. Keep mid plane. This mid plane. And make vert perpendicular so that it lies in center. Again, smart dimension 45. Okay. Now click on this point. And see, the tool is activated. Now place 1, 2. Now escape key to out. You will see the preview. See, in the same way, just do one thing. Show this sketch. hole wizard, same hole, but here the hole diameter is 10. And end condition through all, position, click on the face and find out something in this line, but smart dimension, you need to define a distance, 85, say okay. Now look, the hole is created. Now click line hide. Now we need to make this one. If you see is this view and this view, there is one more flange, see here, this is flange lies here somewhere. Okay, this is the flange 51 millimeter away from here, from bottom edge to here. This flange length 15 millimeter and this is the exact dimension of flange. R13, 10, there is a hole. Same angle 47.04, 85 the center distance. So let's do this. First create a plane. From here make dimension 51, but it is going reverse, so click flip side. Say okay. Okay, let me take, okay, this is the position which help us to do something. Now I'll select this face, convert entity. This is also a good thing. Now let me connect center line, because this center distance is 85. You will see this will help us to do this. Go back and see, it's automatically going to convert into R. Tangent. This point also tangent. Now hold this point, shift, and this point, merge result. Feature, activate smart dimension, radius 13. That's it. Now let's activate extruded boss base. Now here we need to choose only this one, 15 millimeter end condition, but this is moving downward direction, reverse. Say okay. Hide plane. Now there is one hole also, this hole diameter is 10 and there is a 1.5 chamfer also, but after cutting this 43, 15 and 10 millimeter, this is the distance we are going to cut. So let's check which plane is going to, okay, we need to create a plane. Activate temporary axis, activate plane. I'll choose this axis and this axis. You will see the plane is going to create in between. Say okay, click plane, sketch, line, and now we want to cut from upper side, so okay, that's the enough distance, 10, 43, 15. But still I think this is not perpendicular, or it's horizontal. See, this is fully defined sketch. Isometric view. Go to feature and activate, extruded cut. Keep here end condition through all both. Look, this is going to cut in both. But the arrow dimension is going downward. So you have to make reverse, you have to click flip side to cut. Now see, it's going reverse, so that it will cut only upper side, not bottom side. Look, hide plane. Now hide temporary axis from here, hole wizard, hole, drill 10 through all, position, I'll choose this one, and you will find if you keep cursor near, That's it. Say okay. That's it. Even though I'll prefer not to keep, because see, it's going to cut through all, not through all, keep only next. Next means this backside face. Say yes. Now click on the edge and you will get option fillet chamfer. I'll choose chamfer 0.5. This is angle distance chamfer 0.5, 45 degree. Now let's create this face, this feature. You will see. Now you will see there is a object, extra object. This is 28 millimeter from bottom edge. You will see 28 millimeter, 11 millimeter thick. But this is the dimension. You will see this hole lies on center. 20 millimeter, this distance 40 millimeter, 15 angle, and the corner radius R7. This corner fillet R10. Then there is one cutout, 3 millimeter cutout at its center. So we will create a mid plane, then we will cut it. Now let's create a activate plane from bottom, 28 millimeter reverse. Click offset, say okay. Now click on the plane sketch. Now this position is not perfectly good for us, so I'll, okay, we are going somewhere here. So first I'll draw center lines. These are the important thing. Okay. Now, it is tangent to somewhere here. Now, somewhere like this, and vertical to this line. Select this circle, convert entity. So, no need to draw, even though you can draw. Let's define this angle first. 15 degree. Fillet 7, corner fillet, so okay, so we will get a center point. Now hold shift key and this line coincide, this is important. Forty millimeter. Okay, now this line and point, okay, again I'll select both the line and tangent. That's it. Now important distance, this one, 20. Now our drawing is completed. Trim entity, power trim, and trim this one. So we have a perfect shape. Even though we need to trim here also. Activate extruded boss base feature, and this is 11 millimeter, but this is upside. So make reverse direction. Say okay. Hide plane. Now create a mid plane between. Activate plane. I'll choose both the back surfaces, and it's going to happen a mid plane. Say okay. Now click on the mid plane sketch. Simply I'll choose this face and click convert. We don't need to do one. We have to make a corner fillet here, 10 millimeter. This is 10 millimeter. Now it's okay. That's it. Now apply. Sketch, select this face, convert entity, look, activate extruded cut feature. 3 millimeter we need to cut, but end condition mid plane. See, it's going to cut in both sides. Say yes. Let me hide plane. Now you will see proper view. hole wizard. There is a two holes, DIN standard drill size. Five diameter and condition here we can keep through all position. I'll select this face and just keep cursor near and you will find center point. Escape key or select. See. Now let's start to create this flange. 200 millimeter from center to here. The outer diameter R12. Then 80 millimeter, there is a step, 80 millimeter straight. And this thickness you will see in section view. This is the section view. This upper side detail view 32 millimeter, but no, this 30 millimeter is important. This 30, and we have to create a plane 22 millimeter from top edge. See, this side is top, and 30 millimeter width. Then this corner fillet, you will see R50. Then there is one inside, there is a cutout 14 millimeter, 40 millimeter. This is the main cutout. These things we will do it. So activate plane, select this 22 millimeter, make offset, okay, sketch. Now let's start. First I'll select this circle, convert entity. Now let me draw a circle line which help us to grove. Go back and see converted into, and somewhere here make sure these lines are vertical. Now select these three lines, symmetric relation. Okay, we don't need this one right now. Okay, let's do one thing. These points merge, this point tangent, make sure all these points are tangent. Okay, these two lines I think equal. Okay, let's define 200, 80, 12, radius 12. That's it. Activate extruded boss base feature, and I'll choose this one because there is too close geometry. 30 millimeter, keep end condition mid plane. See, say okay. Let me hide. Oh, we need this plane again. Okay. Let me choose again this plane, sketch. I'll select this face, convert entities, line. Now let's define this distance. Select this one and hold shift key and distance, click top face, and you will get the distance from top edge, 40 millimeter. Okay, trim entity, and I'll trim this one. If anything, just trim all this thing. Activate extruded cut tool. 14 millimeter end condition, keep mid plane. Say yes. Look. Now let me hide. Activate fillet tool and constant size fillet and keep 50 millimeter radius. Same in both sides. Now let's make this cutout. You will see this cutout 36 kilometer from here, and this lies at this center, R8 radius, corner radius, 5 millimeter distance from here, inside radius R8, okay. Then this depth you will see here, 30 minus 9 millimeter divided by 2, you will see here. Then the same thing in opposite direction, 36, but there is a one catch, it is shaped like this, 16, 8, 8, 5, 5. And this depth also same like 30 minus 9 divided by 2. And there is a two holes, 3.5 two holes. This distance you will notice 45 millimeter, 55 from here. One more hole, R12, this 35 millimeter. And this is throughout hole. You will see in drawing. See? Now, I'll select this face, sketch. Now, let me do one thing. Okay. Let's start from here. Line up to this arc. Now, mirror entity, I'll mirror these two lines against this line. Okay. I'll choose this line, convert entity. It is really help us to do things. Merge. Okay. Now, let's create relation. Parallel. Now, the same here also. Parallel. Dimension. Millimeter. 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 Trim entity, I am going to trim this one. Keep power trim active. Okay. Sketch fillet. This radius 8 millimeter. So I'll choose these two ends. Similarly, these two ends. Say okay. Look. This is fully defined sketch. Activate extruded cut. And here the distance is close. 30 minus 9 divided by 2. See, enter. It is 10.5 is the depth. Say OK. Now go back. Sketch. Now here again I will draw one center line which help us to. Line, convert into arc, again convert into arc, again convert into arc, and connect with this line. Okay, let's create few important relation. Hold shift key, parallel. This is important relation, parallel. Okay, tangent point, tangent point. These all are tangent point. Hold shift key, these two equal. Now define dimensions. 36, 5 millimeter. Now, there is one more important, this center point lies on this line. Now, this distance, it's defined. Look, this is going to this. R8. This is R16. Okay, there is some misbalance happened here. Now delete some relations so that we will get back our geometry. Okay, let me delete this line. Okay. Now activate 3-point arc. Okay. This point and this point merge tangent. Okay. R16. This point also. Now this is fully defined. R8, this corner also. Activate extruded cut tool. Same 10.5. If you calculate 30 minus 9 divided by 2, enter 10.5. You will see. Now there is a hole. So hole wizard, hole, and that is (3.5mm) two hole. And hole, we will not go through all, we will choose up to next position. Select this face. 1, 2. Escape key to out. Hold shift key and select these three holes. Vertical relation. Smart dimension. (45mm) distance. From here to this midpoint, (55mm). This is fully defined. Say OK. Again, the same hole we are going to create, but this time this is bigger hole. 12mm. Up to next end condition, position, I'll choose this face, put somewhere here, escape key tool, hold shift key, vertical. Okay, it is about this distance. Because this is going to meet with this hole. Say okay. Now look. Now here I'll show you the fillet. Corner radius, we'll see 2mm, inside radius 4mm. You will see here also 4mm. Then there is one counter bore hole, you will see in detail view. R17, 2mm, this hole 8mm. But there is one step, 32mm. So this step is 1mm. If you minus 30, 32 minus 30 by 2, it will be 1mm. And the same circle like this. And then we will mirror this one, this counter bore hole, and this corner radius R 0.5. Now let's activate fillet. Constant size fillet 8mm. In the same way, these two side, say okay. Fillet 4mm. I'll choose inside. Clear and select inside edge only, not the hole. Now the same here, I'm going to choose inside edge, so that it's going to cover all inside edges. Okay, again activate fillet tool, this time 2 millimeter, and I'll select this outer edge. That's it. Now select this face, sketch, circle, and let me activate circle tool and up to 24 millimeter. Smart dimension 24. Extruded boss base. Keep end condition 1. See merge result. Okay. Now activate hole wizard. Here choose legacy hole, counter bore, the outer inside diameter 8, depth, for depth I'll choose end condition, so I'll keep next, so that it will cut only this flange, 17 bore diameter and 2 millimeter is the depth, position, select this face and keep cursor and you'll find origin point or center point. Say OK. Now look. Now let's select boss, hole wizard, mirror entity. These two features we want to mirror, but is that any plane available for this? Right plane. No. Not right plane. We need to find the plane what we created for this. Plane 6. See, we created a plane in between this. Say OK. That's it. It is mirror. Now here, if you see this section view, L. So, in that position, you will see here, this counter bore hole. This is 12 outer dia, depth 1 millimeter and 8 mm hole diameter inside. 39 from bottom side, 45 from second one. So these two holes we need to create. And we will create this center hole, 45 diameter, one chamfer at both corner, 1 millimeter. And there is a radius. This corner R1, activate radius 0.5, you forget to mention this, okay, now hole wizard and I'll choose a hole here, drill size. And let's standard we will choose metric, dowel, drill size, and the diameter it's 45. If you want find diameter 45, simply click custom show 45. Keep here end condition through all. Say OK. I'll select this face and put at center. Check isometric view. Escape tool. OK. See. Now I'll activate chamfer tool and I'll select inside edge. 1 millimeter 45 degree angled distance. Now, I'll select this face because this is the face we are going to create. Counter hole wizard, counter bore hole actually we need to create. Legacy, now counter bore, now comes inside diameter 8 millimeter, that's fine. And for depth, we will see the conditions. Counter bore hole 21, 1 millimeter is the depth. And don't keep this one through all. We need to choose, let's say up to next, what will happen. Position, I'll choose somewhere here. Second one here, skip, hold shift key. Okay, smart dimension. Now this is the distance from bottom, it's 39, and the center to center is 45. That's it. But now let's check what we choose. Okay, we choose next. Let's say okay. Okay, the hole is perfectly created. That's fine. Now see, this is happened just because something wrong with this face. Click this one. Okay, boss. Edit. Now check here. See, this is not lies on perfectly. Delete. Now select this one and this one, horizontal. Again activate 80 millimeter. Make sure it is vertical. Tangent face. Okay, this is not perfectly, so put this coincide. That's it. Now exit from the sketch. Now check again. See, this is perfectly happens. Fillet, this is 1 millimeter, and this is the and top edge. Okay, now check here, this corner radius R5, some more radius you will see inside R5. Now this flange also R5. Now there is a one hole, 8 millimeter through hole, 30 millimeter angle from the top view. If you, so the plane should be lies on the perpendicular to this hole. So it means 30 minus 90 minus 30 is 60. So plane somewhere lies here. I'll show you with this. Now activate fillet. Now, the first one, this one, this one, this edge, this edge. This edge and this corner. Okay. These are the 5 millimeter. Let's choose the right temporary axis. If I am going to select this view, okay, I'm going to create a plane like this. So I'll choose right plane. Plane. Okay. Now one more reference. So I'll choose, okay, this axis, activate angle 60 degree. Now look, if this position we are going to create, then we are able to create a hole at center and is going to cut through at 30 degree, because if you check perpendicular, it's become 30 degree here. Say okay. Now I'll okay. Now choose line. Now the 8 millimeter hole and distance is 22 millimeter from one end. If you see, select extruded cut and keep end condition through all both. This is going to be create a hole. Say okay. Let me hide plane, hide temporary axis. See, this hole is here. So this is the simple tutorial we did in SolidWorks. Not simple, a kind of complicated or kind of advanced tutorial. You learned many things here. Now let's activate real view and brushed finish, nickel, okay. So don't forget to share and like our video, and please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks for such a kind of projects. In let's try to make a 2D drawing with the help of this in our next tutorial. Please subscribe and share our channel. Thanks for watching.